I'm honored today to co-convene the first global refugee forum with the leaders of Turkey, Ethiopia, Germany, and Costa Rica. I thank especially the government of Switzerland and the UNHCR for hosting the forum. I commend Secretary General and High Commissioner Grandi for the strong advocacy of the refugee causes. But I want to especially pay a tribute to President Erdogan of Turkey and the people of Turkey for hosting the largest refugee population. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I want to speak about Pakistan. Pakistan was born out of the biggest refugee problem in the history of mankind. And we were inspired by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was a refugee. I'm very proud to say that Pakistan hosted at 1.4 million refugees, and still, after 40 years, Pakistan still has 1.4 million registered refugees, and overall the Afghans in Pakistan number 3 million. Countries that do not have resources, countries that cannot look after their own population, that cannot provide their basic needs, that are struggling to develop their human resources. For them, a large refugee population causes problems which cannot be imagined by the richer countries. I see the European countries struggling with the refugee problems. I see the emergence of the right wing, which cashes in on the public distress faced by the public because of lack of jobs. They cash in on the refugees. So we in Pakistan have been through this. 4 million refugees, and today almost 3 million refugees, a country where there's massive unemployment. We know what we go through. As a prime minister, I can tell you that we face daily problems where our people want jobs, and clearly the refugees can become a target. But I'm very proud of my people, the way the people of Pakistan have hosted the refugees. The hospitality shown to the refugees for over 40 years. But the main point I want to make here today is that prevention is better than cure. We must all try and prevent people from becoming refugees. Pakistan is, and again, I'm proud to say we are trying our best now in the peace process in Afghanistan so that the refugees can go back with dignity. And we are praying that this peace process now succeeds. There's a political settlement in Afghanistan so that the people of Afghanistan who've been suffering for 40 years of conflict, finally, they too can enjoy the dividends of peace. Mr. Secretary General and High Commissioner, one of the things I especially wanted to come here and point out, and I do want to tell the whole world, that they should be aware of one of the biggest impending refugee crises about to take place. In India, on the 5th of August this year, India laid siege, Indian forces laid siege to the people of Kashmir. Since 5th of August, 8 million Kashmiris have been literally shut inside. Their rights have been taken, people have been imprisoned, the leaders are in jail, all communication has been cut off. But the most important thing which the world needs to understand is that the professed aim is to change the demography of Kashmir from a Muslim majority to a Muslim minority. Now, if this is what the professed aim is, we are likely to have another refugee crisis. A refugee crisis that would dwarf other crises. In the United Nations General Assembly, I tried to appeal to the world community that they must take notice of this. What is going to happen? The people are under siege in Kashmir. Whenever the curfew is lifted, there are 900,000 Indian troops there. What is going to happen then? They're trying to change the demography by settling in Hindu population into Kashmir. What is going to happen then? So we know from our past experience, prevention is better than cure. If the world acts right now and puts pressure on the Indian government to stop this illegal activity, we could prevent this crisis. But we all know once a crisis starts, once there is a crisis, we all know that it's as we know right now, as we know what is happening, as we know what is going on in Turkey with the refugees, we all know that it's very difficult, it's complicated. So many issues come in the way. So number one, I would like the world community to take notice of what is happening. We in Pakistan are not just worried that there'll be a refugee crisis. We are worried that this could lead to a conflict between two nuclear-armed countries. And so the Secretary General of UN is sitting here. I'm looking forward to inviting you to Pakistan in February when we host the refugee conference there. But I would really appeal to the world community that this is the time to take notice. Secondly, there is another thing happening in India. In Assam, the government has passed a Citizen Registration Act. What does that mean? That means that every citizen has to prove their citizenship. This is what happened in Myanmar. Before the ethnic cleansing of Muslims started there, they were all supposed to first prove their citizenship. This is what is happening in Assam. Some 2 million people, mostly Muslims, are now required to prove that they actually are citizens of India. And according to one of the Indian ministers, the same act will, by 2024, will be all over India. So, along with this act, there is another law just recently passed that from Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Bangladesh, any minority that is persecuted can find citizenship in India. That means that anyone except Muslims can find citizenship in India. So therefore, if you put these two acts together, when this act goes all over India, where every citizen will have to prove their citizenship, Secretary General, please understand the implications. There are 200 million Muslims in India. So anyone who cannot prove the registration will be deregistered as a citizen. Except that all other religious minorities, Hindus, Sikhs, Christians, they can come back and seek asylum in India, so they will get citizenship, but not Muslims. So there are 200 Muslims in India. If 2 or 3% of them cannot prove their citizenship, where will they go? So this is another thing. There are riots in India already. People are out in the streets. I would urge the international community to please look into this, because we know once the crisis happens, it's much more difficult. I repeat, it's much more difficult to control it. It's much easier right now for the world community to step in and see what is happening. And that I urge them, because we in Pakistan stand to suffer. As it is, a country that is hosting 3 million refugees, a country which is trying to develop its own human beings, provide them the basic necessities, our country will not be able to accommodate more refugees. So I urge, I especially came here, Mr. Secretary General and High Commissioner, I especially came here that this is the time for the world community to take notice. What is happening next door can have consequences, can have an impact on the refugee population of the world, which is unprecedented. Thank you.
وزیراعظم عمران خان جنیوا میں ہونے والے دو روزہ گلوبل ریفیوجی فورم سے خطاب کر رہے تھے. وزیراعظم عمران خان نے کہا کہ بھارت جو کچھ کر رہا ہے انسانی المیہ ایک مرتبہ پھر پیدا ہونے جا رہا ہے, جہاں پر عالمی برادری اس کا نوٹس لے. اور آسام میں 20 لاکھ مسلمانوں کی شہریت منسوخ ہونے کا خطرہ ہے, جبکہ وہاں پر ریاض بھی شروع ہو چکے ہیں, وہاں پر فسادات شروع ہو چکے ہیں. وزیراعظم عمران خان نے اس کے ساتھ ساتھ کہا کہ پاکستان نے سب سے زیادہ مہاجرین کی میزبانی کی ہے. اس کے ساتھ ساتھ وزیراعظم عمران خان نے ترک عوام اور ترک صدر رجب طیب اردوان کا بھی خراج تحسین پیش کیا کہ وہ اس وقت دنیا میں مہاجرین اور پناہ گزینوں کی سب سے بڑی تعداد کی میزبانی کر رہا ہے. وزیراعظم عمران خان نے کہا کہ 14 لاکھ رجسٹرڈ افغان مہاجرین پاکستان میں موجود ہیں. اس کے علاوہ 30 لاکھ سے زیادہ پناہ گزین پاکستان میں موجود ہیں. پاکستان اپنے وسائل محدود ہونے کے باوجود کھلے دل کے ساتھ, بڑے دل کے ساتھ افغان مہاجرین کی میزبانی کر رہا ہے. اس کے ساتھ ساتھ وزیراعظم عمران خان نے اس فورم سے خطاب کرتے ہوئے مسئلہ کشمیر کے حوالے سے بھی عالمی برادری کو آگاہ کیا. یہ تھی پی ٹی وی تازہ ترین. مزید باخبر رہنے کے لیے ہمارے ساتھ رہیے.